Often we look at a crew from side on and think that we can see what's going on. You actually can only see part of the story. If you look at this drone footage from above, you can see lots of things. So a really good angle to see is from a drone or someone running under a bridge. You can see here's the drone and the controller, and you can see our cameraman here sending the drone out over a boat so that we can observe this quad from above. As you can see here, it's very clear on the screen, and here's the footage that we took. Now, if you look at this very carefully, you can see lots of things. If we look at a few things we can see, and we'll discuss them more in future videos, if you look here in particular, you can see the angles of the oars. And I'll just highlight one just for example. If you look at this oar here compared to this oar here coming into the catch, then clearly there's some things we can do to adjust that. Now, it may be a technique issue, or it may be something as simple as rigging in the boat. And so what I'd suggest you do is with this sort of footage is look for the types of things that you can adjust easily. If you look here with the athletes rowing along, viewing from the side, you can't see anywhere near as much detail as to what's going on. You can see some things a bit better, particularly posture, but arguably you can see posture from above as well. So you can see here the crew doing a racing start, and you can see all sorts of issues with angles. And so particularly if you look at the angles of the oars, you can see a number of things. Firstly, we can see, if we look here, you can see that there's different angles amongst some of the oars, particularly on this side of the boat. If we look further at a few other bits of detail, you can see the way these blades are going into the water, who's in the water first, who's in later. If we go along a little bit further, then you can see that there's marked differences between the catches. So lots of things that you can see very clearly from above. It's very difficult if you're in a boat alongside the rowing crew to be able to observe both sides of the boat, i.e. it's difficult to see what's happening with the catches on one side versus the other. Other things you can see here too. You can see quite clearly that if we look at the arms of the athletes at the catch, you can see that they're very straight, there's no kink in the arms, so clearly good technique. If we look at other items here running through, you can see a few little things. For example, if we look at the hands here, you can see that we've got slight mismatches in relation to where the hands are in relation to the blade, and so there's some technique things we can change there. Sure, you can see some of those things from the side on, but nowhere near as well as you can from above. If we go forward a little further, you can see here where the blade goes past square off. If we look at the same position of the athlete, you can see this blade here is on this sort of angle, and this one's on this. Quite easy to fix again by just moving the position of the foot stretcher in this case and seeing where it is best to get the athletes lined up correctly. If you go through to the, if we go through to the catch, then it's quite easy to make small adjustments to where their foot stretcher is in relation to this. You can also see how the blade's going into the water. Is it going in on an angle, or is it going in quick and get connected quite deep? You can actually see the point of connection. If you look carefully from above, you can see the point at which they're connected, and you can compare the angles at that point. And for example, here we have a particular issue compared to, say, these two. Little things that will make a lot of difference. And when they get past square off, about here where the most power is applied, we can see things like, if we look here, we can see differences in blade depths because of the transparency of the water. We can see the power being applied if we look at the two stroke oars compared to the two bow oars. You can see that there are different stages of power application at different parts of the stroke. If we have them all together, then we're going to get much better outcomes. So really handy to be able to see from above. There's lots of things you can see that you can't actually see from when the athletes are side on. There are some things we can see better from side on, for example, posture and the blade height above the water and the like, but there's far more you can see when filming from above. With a drone, it's quite easy. One of the difficulties with filming from above is, of course, you need a drone. If you're lucky enough to live in an area where there's a bridge, then I'd suggest just film the athlete going under the bridge, and you can get the same sort of information, perhaps not as easily, but you can get the same sort of information by watching the athletes go under a bridge. So I'd suggest looking from above, a very useful way to see what's actually happening with many areas of the rowing stroke. And you can watch the blades, the body movements, the way the arms are used, how the elbows are sitting at the finish. There's lots of things you can see from above that are more easily seen from that vantage point and difficult to see from when you're on the water. So I suggest if you can get some footage from above, either from a drone or from rowing under the bridge, I'd suggest you should do that. A lot of this footage we're analysing in more detail for various aspects of the stroke, such as angles, blade depths, etc. And you can see those in our other videos. So, view from above, a really useful way to look at the rowing stroke.